He's loose with the right hand, and he starts to retaliate, and down goes Nyland, and the two of them are hammering each other.
Knights of Columbus, that hurt!
It's old time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordie Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky's, the Muser, Bobby Orr's.
The enforcer of all hockey podcasts. It's the Biscuit. It's the Biscuit. The enforcer of all hockey podcasts.
God help the fucking day if fighting's ever banned. There's a country we'll stop working on so badness fucking can.
Hi, everybody. It's the Biscuit Podcast.
Hey, wanna go? Yeah, okay. Good luck, man. Good luck to you too, buddy.
Hey, Meltlow. I ended up getting a great interview with a certain Casey Bellamy.
Last night you did an interview with Casey? Nice.
Yeah, to kick off the Friday night. And then hung out with the family and ate some Greek food and nothing too crazy. But, dude, last Sunday, I got in one, dude. And Monday morning I thought I was going to die.
On football Sunday last week?
Yeah, it was rough. Oh,
fuck.
Dude.
That's brutal.
Wife brought a 12-pack home. I killed that. I was... You know, after football, Bengals got their ass kicked. I'm DJing in the living room, just dancing with all the kids. Crush that 12-pack, go get another one. I'm like, I should not drink this. So I do. And, dude, it was like 4:30 until Monday morning where I didn't even feel like a human.
That's the worst, man.
Did you get at it last night?
A little bit. It's my girlfriend's birthday today, so...
Happy birthday. What's her name?
I just hung out with her family and shit, and I had some beers.
What's her name?
Kaylee.
Kaylee. Happy birthday, Kaylee.
Happy.
Do you have any, hangover? Like, you know, certain people would be like, oh, you got to chug 3 gallons.
I don't really get that hungover.
What?
Yeah, I swear to God, man. Like, if I do, it's because I drank a bump.
So you just got
if I'm hungover, I get fucking like right at it with breakfast and just try and shovel some.
Yeah, I get them bad. I get them like for 2 days. It sucks. There's nothing you can do. When you get one bad, it's just like you're just in the shit. You there? Yeah, I can now. You there?
Yeah, I'm here.
This fucking internet, man. I swear to God.
It's the worst.
I'm on
full Wi-Fi now. It wasn't like 2 seconds ago.
I'm fucking plugged into the goddamn modem and it still won't matter. The fucking... Figure the fucking internet out.
Yeah, it's like, you know, and not everybody's shit works the same. It's always fucking nuts.
I've got a. Do you want to start this off with a? I got a fan story. Somebody sent me one here about you.
You got a fan story about me?
Yeah.
Fucking right. Yeah. Let's start off with that.
So this is sent off Facebook. Here we got this the other day. He's from Doug Washaball.
Oh yeah, beauty from Cape Cod. He lives on Cape Cod up here.
Yeah, he said he's a buddy of yours here. So
yeah.
Now, Doug. Next time you send a story and proofread this motherfucker, because this thing is brutal, dude.
Come on, Dougie.
He says, hey, William, just want to let you know I absolutely love the show. I'm on Cape Cod, a huge fan here. And now they have my buddy Corey Bellamy on, it's even more awesome. I actually have a funny story that involves Corey. It was a fight where Corey was fighting Chris Saffinetti. We talked pretty good about that one on your solo episode there, so you guys can go back and check that one out. You can also find, I think, all your fights with Affinity on Hockey Fights, too.
Yeah, a lot of them around there, yeah.
And Joe Peace. So this is the one where Joe Peace came off the bench and jumped you at center ice. I remember this one. And
after I was fighting Affinity, yeah.
Yeah, it comes out of nowhere. And all hell breaks loose. Doug here, he's working the penalty box doing, I think he means during a point streak for the Bluefins. or something. I don't know what the fuck that sounds.
Yeah, he was working the box. He was working in the box, like, you know, giving the boys, like, the towels and the water and shit, and, like, making sure we had tape or something, making sure we had, you know.
Okay.
If we needed to get fixed up in there, he would help us out.
So, Chris squirts water bottle in his face while Corey and Chris are chirping, and he walks in between the glass, and he says he punches Chris right in the helmet. He says, you can't see it on the video, but another fight broke out, and Doug here, I ended up having to fight off half their team who tried to kill me with their sticks over the glass. Crazy thing is, I get thrown out of the game along with a few other Bluefins players, and the referee who has to throw them out, none other than Doug the Thug Smith, who was a referee at the FHL, says crazy times in that gonk show, but it was good times, and I got to meet great people like Corey being one of them. One of my favorite guys to watch. He played old-time hockey. He said, I'd love to hear the story on the breakfast show. Love what you guys are doing. Keep up the great work.
Yeah, man, it was wild. I think we were in Cape Cod playing in Hyannis. And, yeah, it ended up getting, it ended up escalating into the box, I think, because Pace, you know, hadn't gotten kicked out. So it was like Aphrodite, Pace, you know, Chris Testa, backup goalie, comes off the bench, fucking starts throwing bones. I actually have a picture of that. I'll have to send it to you.
Yes, please do.
And there's a picture of just, you know, fucking Chris Testa sitting there like a turtle on top of all of us. And there's, you know, three of us under him. So, like trying to, you know, looking like a mom out there trying to be like, that's my kid.
My favorite part is the dude working the penalty box got thrown out of the game, too. That's hilarious.
Yeah, Dougie, what a beauty. Yeah, yeah, there's some crazy fucking stories that, you know, in the FHL, man. So, and that's just one of them.
I knew Doug, he's... You know, former guest of the show, Doug Smith, had been a referee, but I didn't realize he was refereeing FHL games.
Yeah, that's wild. I didn't really put two and two together either myself, because I wasn't, you know, I didn't know too much about refs going into pro hockey. I didn't, you know who was who, so.
Yeah, so when you play, you just pretty much play whoever the refs are, it's whatever.
Yeah, I mean, I never looked into any of that shit. I mean, they all hated me anyway. I fucking was running around. You know,
shit, dude.
Yeah, I always had a target on my back going in the corners. I knew I had to keep my elbows low. You know, can't be jumping into guys. So I was a pretty good hitter, though. I was always clean about most of the shit I did.
Now, have you seen this the figure skating thing that happened the other day?
I didn't see it when you texted me that. I hadn't seen that yet. What was it?
So I'm trying to find the exact story. It was it happened in Sheffield, and
what, in the EIHL?
I'm pretty sure. So
yeah, the Sheffield Steelers, maybe their name is.
Yeah, it's definitely because the team was orange, and I saw that. I'm trying to find a bunch of people sent it to me. I should have had this pulled up previously here, but I didn't. So, how do I type in super lame figure skating? Anyway, these two players, they meet, like, at center ice, like they're almost going to fight, and then...
Oh my god, I did see the video now that you're talking about it, yeah.
Okay, so it looks like, you know, a pageantry fight, right?
Yeah, it looks like they're about to line square up, they're, like, going circling, yep, and then they start fucking dancing, right?
Yes.
What a fucking joke. I'm pretty sure I commented on it, and a lot of people didn't like it, a lot of people did, but I just commented simply, there's no time for that shit in hockey. It's like a junior fucking game. It's like a junior game.
So it was not the Steelers then?
I don't know if it was or not. I hope it wasn't, because that would be embarrassing.
Yeah, that would make it even worse. How the fuck can I not find it?
Especially because that's a pretty good fucking league. You know, they can't be having that shit going on. I'll tell you that.
Figure. I think the internet's trying to bury it here.
Yeah.
But... It was like you said, about 50-50, some people like it, some people didn't. It kind of reminds me of the surge that the Hurricanes do.
And yeah, in the beginning or the end of the game there.
Yeah, now how do you feel about that?
I mean, I guess it's the market they're in. You know, teams like the Blackhawks don't have to do that shit because they know what the fuck the product they're going to see. I mean, I guess in Carolina, you know... There's a lot of people that are trying to just, you know, they're trying to get people to the game. And, you know, it's good for the kids, I guess. But there's no harm in it. It's at the end of the game. game, as long as, you know, guys are winning games and doing their shit. But, it's a little over the top with some of the shit they do. But I think they calmed it down since last year, no?
Yeah, I'm not even – are they still doing it?
I don't know. I haven't been paying attention much at all about, like, you know, I've just been following the Bruins.
Well, that's the main thing. No one follows the fucking Hurricanes anyhow, so no one would really know anyway. You know what I mean?
Right, yeah. But I know Dougie Hamilton's playing real well. That guy's somehow putting together, like, a fucking unbelievable season.
Now, he's the guy where it seems like if he's happy in the room, he's an elite defenseman, but they say he can be a fucking, and I obviously don't know, I've never been in the locker room with him, but a fucking disease in the room. Like, in Calgary, they said he was just the piss, dude.
Oh, man, yeah, he's, that's what I've heard, too. I heard the same things you just said. But, I mean, it's kind of working for him now down there. I mean, I remember the hit last year where Ovi was coming down hot on him in the playoffs, and he just fucking shied away, and Ovi just grabbed the puck, and they score out in front.
Yeah.
Remember that play?
Yeah.
Remember that play? Oh, my God. It was embarrassing to watch.
And then the thing for me is I always have to remind myself that not everybody is like a 30-year-old guy watching hockey. So, like, if I think it's lame or whatever, I also have to remember that, like, there might be some kids, like you said, in Carolina who think it's cool. They're like, oh, dude,
right.
I want to win. And then it gets them into the game. Do I think it belongs in the NHL? No, but... it's not for me to say. Like, I don't have to watch it, and I don't. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I mean, I feel like, you know, it's almost, it's not reaching, but, I mean, you got to think that the attendance in Carolina is not too high. It's probably in the middle of the league or something. I'm sure they get, like, you know, 12,000, 15,000 a game. I'm pretty sure, and that's on the lower side in the NHL now, somewhere on, like, 10 a game isn't that good in the NHL, you know?
Right.
You want, like, 20,000 people at the game.
Yeah, I think that's the ideal number. And you got, I mean... you watch a Detroit game and their stadium's empty, and you're like, "Oh man!"
Ooh. Yeah, and they were unbelievable for years. And their fan base is still big. No one just wants to go there. I mean, I don't. That's wild.
It's crazy, and I'm like, man, they build this brand new barn. It's like state of the art, and all you're seeing is fucking backs of seats.
Yeah. Well, they didn't make the. They made the playoffs for like what 23 years straight, 24, and they haven't made it the last two or three.
Yeah. Yep, and so, it's not cheap to go to Little Caesars Arena either.
No, it is. No, I can imagine. I imagine that those tickets are pretty high because it just got built.
Yeah, exactly. It's like you hear people say they go to like a Maple Leafs game. It's like every bit of $180 to sit up in the shit.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and it's crazy. Yeah, the markets, like, that's the biggest market in the NHL.
Yeah.
You know. And it's probably, you know, that and Montreal are probably the two biggest, and then you got Boston, Chicago.
Yeah.
The original six teams do. You know, Philly does really well.
Rangers.
Yeah, Rangers, but even like the Coyotes are doing really well with all that shit right now. Like, they're playing well.
Yeah, Coyotes are playing real well, and you know, they've been doing some cool things out there too in the desert. They ended up giving a contract to a 8-year-old girl who's battling cancer. I don't know exactly.
Freaking awesome. Awesome. I saw that.
That kind
of... Ekman-Larsson. Oliver Ekman-Larsson let her take the face off, too. It was pretty awesome to watch.
That's incredible. And that's the stuff where, like, I'd rather see that than the Surge, but there's different ways to, you know, to work it out. But that shit chokes me up, man. I almost start crying when I see it.
Well, yeah, imagine being in the kid's shoes, you know what I mean? Battling, and then you get an opportunity like that.
Oh, yeah, and it... You know, before the game, she's given the pregame speech, and then I think it's Derek Stepan, you know, lets her rub his head, and she lets the whole team rub her head for good luck, and then
then they
give her a freaking contract. That's beyond cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool what you can do on the platform they have up there in the NHL.
And then they ended up having now, can you call it a line brawl if everyone keeps their gloves on?
Yeah, I mean, it would probably be a bunch of double minors, but...
I saw today this fucking guy who writes for ESPN, Greg Wyshynski. He's a fucking dork. And he ended up saying something like, all two-minute major penalties, you know, they'll run the whole length. So I was like, what the fuck is a two-minute major?
Oh, my God. So, like, you can't get... it'll be locked in even if they score?
Exactly.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, but dude, that'll happen. I guarantee that'll happen.
Yeah, the way hockey's going right now, it seems to be trending that way.
Now, did you see the brawl? I think it was Darcy Kemper and I think Matty Tkachuk got into
it. Yeah, I saw like they were messing around and then Kemper grabbed Tkachuk and like pulled him down.
Uh-huh.
Then he started to throw a Kemper, Kachuk's throwing at Kemper.
Jesus, dude.
You don't get to see that in the NHL nowadays where guys are going after a goalie, but
no. And there's something about a goalie like interaction or fight where it even ups the ante a little bit. Maybe it's just like because you never see it, I guess.
Well, that's where half my fight started. I'd get in there and give the goalie a jab, and sometimes the goalie would throw a punch at me. And then, all hell breaks loose when you touch the goalie. It's,
That's like classic Probert, dude. He would do whatever the fuck he wanted to a goalie. Like, daring people. Like, okay, who's going to stop me? If this guy's...
And then that's usually the last shot you take. All right, no one's going to fight me. I'm going to hit the goalie.
Dude, he would wipe...
Probert or run the goalie behind the net.
Yeah, wipe him out behind the net. Be like, hey, you shouldn't have been back here, dude.
Yeah, you keep your head up, bud.
Now there wasn't a trapezoid back then, so he could do whatever the fuck he wanted.
Yeah, fucking Hextall used to be an absolute madman behind there.
Yeah, Hextall, fucking Emery, those guys.
Fuck, dude, Hextall used to fucking fight everybody.
And Wah was a prick.
Wah was a real prick.
Just starting shit, but I think a lot of the Calgary thing was they're not doing very well. Arizona is... And Kemper's on a fucking tear. No one's getting goals on Arizona right now. They're kind of got that.
They have like two goalies. They have fucking like two number ones.
Yeah,
they're back up there.
Antti Raanta.
Yeah, like those are both like number one goalies.
Yeah, two casts out too. Nobody wanted them. They go there and Tockett's. I don't know what he's doing, but those boys are. I mean, both
Tockett's
of them.
A great coach.
Yeah, he seems like the man.
Yeah, that's what That's what I've heard from everybody. Like around. Some other podcasts and whatnot.
Now
that guy's the shit.
The one
to play for.
The one surprise there is they always say he's like a Phil Kessel wrangler, and Kessel's kind of under the radar there a little bit.
Yeah, I don't think he's performing the way he wants to. But when you move to a team like that and whatever, you're going to take a little bit different of a role.
Yeah,
obviously he's still a fucking sniper,
and also
you're playing with different guys, so.
He also might know, too, like, I would let these young guys get it in now, and if we're in playoff contention, Phil could turn it on at any time, probably.
Yeah, seriously. He wheels, too.
That dude could move for a big slob, man.
Yeah. For a bag of milk, he can move.
He does. He does look like a fucking... We used to get these, I don't know if they went across the nation, but at one point during school, they were sacks of milk instead of cartons. And he looks
sacks
like...
Sacks of milk?
Yeah, no joke. Like a big plastic...
That's what they have in Canada.
Yeah, what the fuck is that all about?
Yeah, I don't know. Canadians have it, like, they have bags of milk, people. And I think it's, like, still delivered, too.
Well, that sounds...
pretty crazy. We have some friends out in Canada that we'd always... it was always so funny. And one of them would eat ketchup with their fucking French toast. I thought that was the most disgusting thing I ever fucking seen, but...
That's criminal.
Yeah, you can't be doing that.
What? How would that even happen in your life?
Yeah, how do you even get there?
That makes no sense. Like, that makes... Oh, dude, that's fucking gross.
Yeah, I would not recommend that. I'm a big syrup guy with butter.
Yeah, it's got to be syrup. It's got to be real syrup, too.
Yeah. Or even the flavored shit. The flavored butter syrup, Mrs. Buttersworth or something. No, ooh. That shit is cracked.
There's a few families here that make like real maple syrup, and it's fucking expensive as shit, but it is so goddamn good. I mean, it's like $12.
What is it, like a nice, like homemade out of a maple tree, like all the whole nine yards, like a Sugar Shack thing?
Yep, that's exactly what it is, man. These guys like painstakingly make this shit once a year, and it costs like $15 for it, but oh my God, dude, it's so good.
It costs a bunch of money.
And the the process is like, dude, these hillbillies sit out in these fucking shacks and sit there and drink, and like it takes hours and hours and gallons and gallons of syrup to get like a fucking little bit. I don't know.
Yeah, because it burn off so much water out of it or whatever.
Oh, just fuck all of it. It's all burn off, and then they get like three drips out of it. I'm like, I don't know, man. There's got to be a better way here.
Seriously, like, how do they even? I think they just, like, put a nice, like, they hit a, like, hole in it, right? And then put, like, a...
Yep.
Like, a pipe almost, and then a bucket on top of that pipe, and it just drains out into it.
Yeah, I think that it's almost like a siphon, like, where you ever, like, siphon gas or something like that.
So, wild.
So, like, once they get it running, they all just collects in, like, one bin. Dude, here's a fucked up story, and this is... I was a very young kid, so probably sixth grade. There's a few maple farms out in the country here. And me and my buddy went out to him and fucking pulled the hose off and pissed down the fucking, pissed down the hose, dude.
Oh my God. You, so, that is, that's quite a fucking way, one way to do it.
I mean.
Holy fuck.
That's just pure criminal.
That's criminal is right.
That is, like, I don't know if they'd have to throw out their whole batch or, like, if it, someone probably, you know, had my piss with their fucking. With their pancakes one morning.
Oh my God, you filthy son of a bitch.
You think about it now, I'm like, dude, that's some like fucking independent farmer's like paycheck.
Yeah, way of living.
Yeah, and I just pissed at it. That's so shitty, dude. It's got to be statute of limitations, though. Come at me. I'm not going to jail again.
Again.
Now, fucking. Dude, I cannot find this thing, and I'm looking through my mentions on Twitter here, and I'm buried underneath Don Cherry hate, and then I got in this fucking argument with this dork about something else, and all I've got is just pure hatred on my Twitter account, so I cannot find where the fuck this game was.
Fucking Don.
Fuck it. Don, fuck it.
Don's just relaxing now.
So fucking Haley gets put on waivers this week, clears them. I don't think they sent him down yet, but so he's either going to be finding a new home or
if he cleared waivers, usually you go down to the A, right?
Yeah, so I think he's on his way there. I'm surprised nobody picked him up. There's a few teams that could use. I mean, the Maple Leafs could use him. There's a handful of teams that could really use a beefing up, and even maybe just a presence in the room to like, hey, quit being bitches, let's go.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy. I mean, it's crazy you couldn't cut like this early into the year too. You know, playing. I'm sure he's played like 10 of the 20 games teams have played. You know.
Yeah, and he's done very well the past few years. I mean, he gets in the playoffs, and he's just a customer you don't want to fuck with. And I was surprised that they dealt him this year so early too, and because it doesn't seem like you get a fair shake 10 games in.
No. I mean, I'm sure he's been healthy a few times this year, too. You know, that's usually how it goes.
Oh, I guarantee that, yeah.
But.
Yeah, he's got 10 games in. He's got a goal already this year.
Yeah, he's got 10 games and 10 games played in 20 games.
Yeah.
One goal. I mean, that's not usually you'll see a guy even get a goal like him.
No, hell no you don't. And 40 pims, so he's doing his job.
Yeah, he's had a few fights.
Yeah, he's.
Like, that guy's fucking nails.
I mean, as far as guys remaining, if you got to send somebody to go after Reeves, why? I mean, having Michael Haley go after him is not a bad move.
No, not at all. He's not afraid either.
Hell no, dude. Hell no. I did see Biscuit alumni, buddy Zach Rinaldo got called up this week, so I ended up watching a Flames game, and he was out there throwing the body around, man. Looked like Zach Rinaldo. I was happy to see him out there.
That's good. Yeah, he's... They needed a little something in their lineup, you know?
What do you think's going on up there, man?
I don't know, man. They got Lucic up there, so I don't know why they brought him up. I mean, he plays the same game Lucic does, except Lucic has a little more skill than Ronaldo.
Maybe it was like, hey, fucko, get doing something, or, you know, we got other guys in the system here.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, fuck, Lucic isn't what he used to be. He's not a spring chicken, you know?
Now, he gets a lot of shit, too. Sometimes I feel bad for the guy, because whatever he does, people hate him.
Lucic or Ronaldo?
Lucic. Well, I think everybody just hates Ronaldo except for, like, not many.
I mean, he's gotten suspended so many times for some fucking stupid hits. But, like, you know, that's just the way he hits hard. And, like, you know, guys have turned on him. And it's just, you know, the luck of the draw sometimes when you're skating around fucking and flying like him.
Yeah, I think a lot of his are, you know, lined up hit that, you know, like you said, a quarter of a turn at the wrong time, and it's going to make it way worse.
Yeah, and look worse, too, you know.
Yeah. After talking to him, he's not a bad guy. Obviously, I don't know him very well, but it doesn't... What he was saying, he's like, why would I want to keep getting, like, spending all this money? Like, I'm out there to hit guys. That's what I do, and sometimes it goes wrong. And I'm like, well, that makes sense to me, man. I don't know.
Getting fined again.
Yeah, but that's why people fucking hate you, is because they... he's like, hey, yeah, I'm fully aware of that. But hundreds of thousands of dollars, dude. Just,
yeah, boom. It's pretty wild. Like, I'm sure it's fucking not fun getting fined in the NHL.
And they say fucking Lucic is making like $6 million right now too.
Yeah, he's got a heavy contract from Edmonton. Yeah,
so they're not going to be able to move him even if they wanted to. I don't think.
Fucking Peter Chiarelli.
And they are just struggling hard. I mean, they've dropped like seven.
What's their record right now?
It's piss. Let's see here for sure. Calgary. I mean, they're in the bottom of the Pacific.
The whole West.
Are they the worst in the West?
No, are they?
I bet
fucking, I don't know. What do you think's the worst in the West? L.A.
Yeah, he nailed that for sure. L.A. is. L.A. and Minnesota are tied for worst. But
Minnesota's like actually winning some games late as of late, but they started off tough.
Yeah, they've strung. They're on a two-game winner. Calgary's lost six in a row, dude. They're 10, 12, and 3 with six in a row.
That's brutal.
That is...
Fucking Toronto lost six in a row, too, and then they fired Babcock, right?
Yes. So, they won the first game after Babcock, right?
Did they? I didn't see that yet. I haven't seen them play yet, like, with the new coach. Who was Jody Shelley?
I wish it was fucking Jody Shelley.
No, not Jody Shelley. Who the hell is it? The new coach on fucking Toronto.
Jesus Christ, dude.
Not Jody Shelley.
It's a foot. No, it's not foot.
I forget his name. No, Sheldon.
Keefe.
Sheldon.
Keefe. Is it Sheldon Keefe?
Is it? I think it is. I think it is Sheldon Keefe. He used to, he was coaching the Marlies for like 3 years.
And the Marlies had a lot of success. I mean, yeah. They won a Calder. And we've been saying it for weeks that, you know, when you got the young pretty boys going in there saying we don't want to coach for this guy in there or play for this guy, it was only a matter of time. I am personally a guy who doesn't like to see a coach get fired in the middle of a season, let alone the first quarter of the season. What are your thoughts on that? I know you've played for some coaches you didn't like yourself too well, and even some coaches that got fired early. What do you think of all of it?
I mean, it's tough. I mean, I got pretty lucky throughout my, like, pro career. I liked a lot of my coaches. There wasn't anyone I really hated fucking playing for. I mean, I hated not playing sometimes, but that's about it. And I knew we were in some close games. But, I mean, for Babcock to get fired, it just seemed it was trending that way. He's kind of got a fucking pretty big ego to him, you know, like, yeah, he's got a little arrogance to him, you know, and it's probably tough to be around that, especially, like, you know, you don't want to be walking around eggshells with your coach, you know?
Yeah. Well, I know you listen to Chicklets, right? And I know back in the day when I used to listen to them, they'd get Commie on there, Mike Commodore, and he carves
up Babcock.
So what did they end up saying about it? Were they kind of the same thing? Like, just they know that Commodore hated them, or... Did they have any thoughts on it?
You know, about the same thing. Like, you know, like Witt and Biz were saying, like, he's got, you know, he's got that arrogance and a cockiness to him to where, like, you know, he'll go the other way on what people think just to prove him wrong and shit like that, you know, where it's probably not the right way or the right system to go about it, you know?
Yeah, even his parting speech was like, you know, I came here for this guy and Lou Lamoriello and Morgan Riley, fuck everyone else, basically.
Yeah, and he's like, yeah, we, you know, I think we broke a points record. They were in the 100-point range or something. They broke 100, and that was the first time that ever happened in Maple Leafs history, so... Or in a long time.
Where do you think he ends up going? Do you think he stays out of the game because...
Do they have to buy out the rest of his contract?
I'm sure he's got to get a lot of it paid.
Yeah, I know it was front-loaded. Like, he made a lot of money when it was front-loaded. I think he signed for $50
million. Yeah.
I think he was signed, like, a six-year deal for $50
million. So he's going to get, I would bet, another $20 million paid out to him.
Yeah, so I don't think he's going to be too much in a rush to find a job.
Dude, I wouldn't be doing shit.
No, but he loves hockey, I bet, so...
I'd buy a fucking team.
Yeah, I know, right? Fucking, that'd be awesome.
I'd buy fucking Elmira. I'd be the fucking Elmira Enforcer's new owner, coach, player, fucking let's go.
That would be sick. But there's so much shit that goes on fucking in the minors. Like, you know, you gotta really be all over it. But it's all write-off for those rich guys.
Right, yeah. I would definitely be dirty, too. Like, get Tony Soprano in there for taking my trash out, like...
Yeah, start like the Danbury Trashers back in the day.
You ever see that documentary on the Trashers?
Dude, it's fucking... I haven't seen the documentary, but I know some stories.
Dude, that documentary is crazy.
I gotta watch it. I'd love to watch that.
It's I'll send you a link to it. It's fucking great, and...
I mean, I know all about it, like how about like the guy owned a huge disposal company, but he was part of the mob, right?
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Paying guys to come in, there was like some NHL guys playing like on that team, wasn't there?
Yeah, for sure. I think fucking Ferraro played down there.
Yeah, I played with a guy in Elmira that played there, Mario LaRocque.
Dude, there was... I'm missing some names, too. There were some guys who played for fucking the Trashers.
Like, yeah. There's some bigger names that we can't think of right now. I don't know why, but... You gotta pull up that fucking... What was it? The lockout year?
Yeah, it was the lockout year. They got a bunch of fucking guys down there. Oh, yeah. Frank Bialowis played for them.
Yeah. Who was the coach?
Coach for the Danbury Trashers. Let's see here.
I get probably some beauty.
I don't know. I can't find it, but yeah, that.
No, I heard they used to sell out every time. I played in Danbury. There's a fucking. I have a couple sick line brows in Danbury.
Morassi played there. I knew that one. You said you played with Mario LaRocque?
Yeah.
Dude, that's crazy. Where'd you play with him at?
In Elmira. He was like a top draft pick in the draft. Wait, I think he went like fucking high in the draft.
No shit.
To Tampa Bay, yeah. He was like a fucking top 5 or 10 draft pick, I'm pretty sure.
Well, they're not telling me who the fucking coach is. Fuck him. Paul Gillis?
Gillis, it didn't sound familiar, but... Yeah, I've had a couple. Yeah, they used to sell out over there. They fucking don't like me very much in Danbury. They had like they had diapers on the glass with like a fucking my name drawn on it and like a pussy drawn on it or something.
That's fucking
unbelievable. Yeah, I had like a sick mullet too. There's a video of which is fucking me and Anthony Sarno. I'll never forget this. It's online if you look up Cape Cod versus Danbury. And the video just starts and right off the opening face-off. Someone comes and tries and hits Sarno over the bench, and Sarno, Blanchette, that was the kid's name. Sarno fucking hip checks him over the boards, and I just start going to town on this kid.
Is this the one filmed from behind the bench?
Yeah, yeah.
And they're screaming, Bellamy, you pussy!
Yeah, you pussy! Fucking talking to Luke Fry. All of a sudden, Sarno grabs the door while I'm beating the bag out of this kid in the corner and starts hammering the door off this kid's head. I don't think he ever played hockey again. I swear to God.
Jesus Christ, dude.
I know. It's fucked up. Sarno had to get, like, fucking out of there real quick. And then he went down to the ESPY and fucking played, like, 4 games for Pensacola and then retired. But it wasn't, like, he fucking was burying this kid in the dome with this door. And the kid skates away and he could barely skate.
No, I've seen that video, dude, for sure. And the coach in 2005-2006 was Paul Gillis. There's actually a card of him right here. I'm going to buy for $3 right now.
That's unreal.
He's got a fucking head of hair on him, this guy. Sold.
Looking like Jack Capuano.
That'll be, the wife will open up that package and go, "You bought a fucking card of a head coach?" I'm like, I sure did.
Add that one to the fucking wall.
Yeah, tell the lawyer, fucking divorce me, let's go.
Yep.
Bring it.
That's fucking hilarious.
She's pissed anyhow. She's a Wings fan, and Columbus opened up a can on them the other day, so she's got to try and chug a gallon of milk today. It's going to be pretty brutal because it's impossible to do.
Is she going to do it?
Fuck yeah, dude. She pays her dues, man. If she makes
a bet. That's fucking wild. That was the bet? You got to drink a gallon of milk? Was it under in an hour?
I said in 2 minutes. So you just got to chug. Man. Chug.
That'll throw off for sure.
Yeah, definitely. She said I could post it as long as I don't post her puking. I'm like, well, you're definitely going to puke, so.
Yeah.
And if I would have lost, I have to jump in the river off the dock here, but we won.
Nice. You guys live right on the water?
Yeah, we got the river right here, probably like 100 yards from my front door here.
That's pretty freaking awesome.
Yeah, it's nice. I can walk down there, go fishing, sit in the river, drink beer. It's pretty...
It's nice during the summer.
Oh, yeah. It's beautiful, dude. A lot of people drop in their canoes and shit there.
So what are you catching for fish? Like salmon and shit?
Like brown trout.
Trout, yeah.
Creek chub in there. Nothing crazy.
Yeah, I didn't know how big the river was.
It can get pretty big, but it's not huge. It's just a little Clear Fork River. But it's fucking sick. It's nice to have her.
Yeah, wicked nice. Be able to fucking not have a pool and shit, but you're going there.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Is it pretty slow moving?
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice.
There's got to be, I want to find a part of it because the banks can get high that we can put, like, because the old timers there at their barbershop are saying that they used to play hockey on the river, like parts of it that froze over. I'm like, fuck, I'm going to bring that back. They won't let us play at the rink downtown. I'm going to fucking start playing river hockey, man.
Dude, I can't wait till shit starts freezing around here. We got Nickerson State Park over in Orleans. I live in Brewster, Mass.
Uh-huh.
But Orleans, like, is connected right to, Nickerson State Park, which is, like, the next town over from, Orleans is, like, a fucking nice spot. But, like, right in the middle of Brewster and Orleans is this big, big park, and they got a bunch of mini ponds.
Nice.
And they all freeze over, yeah. So you can just go, like, you know, get some ice in down there, carve it up a bit, and then just go to the next pond on fresh ice, you know.
Oh, that's sick.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Did you see, so Matty Calvert took a puck to the face playing Vancouver, Colorado.
Oh, my God.
You saw this, right?
Slapper right to the back of the head, right? Right ear?
Yeah. So he goes down, obviously, face down. And the rule does state that, you know, the ref, it should change possessions, but the ref can stop the game if they feel the player's hurt.
Yeah. They don't have to.
But they don't have to, right. So, and Matty Calvert's taken pucks to the face before. I've seen him score a shorthanded goal to win a game after getting, like, 26 stitches on the bench. He's a fucking warrior.
Yeah, that's fucking beautiful stuff.
And so he's not one to embellish. He's not going to lay down the ice if, you know, just for any reason. Like, that's not in his code, man. So I think it's, like, 14 seconds of him on the fucking ground, like, with his face down. And, you know, Vancouver ends up scoring. I don't know if it was the game tire or to win the game, or, you know, but they... Vancouver,
it was the tire.
Okay, so then Vancouver ends up winning the game, though, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I hear all this shit about player safety, and that's why we're getting rid of fighting, and that's all this jazz. But, like, if you're going to say that player safety's number one, then... I think 14 seconds is fucking long enough for a guy to be wailing on the ground and the opposing team being worried about him that you could fucking pretty much call the whistle there.
Yeah, it didn't look good on the refs, I don't think. But, you know, some guys had some comments after, like, McKinnon was like, you know, if that ever happened to LeBron James, LeBron James was laying on the floor, you know, in their sport. That would never fucking happen.
Dude, LeBron James stubs his toe, they're fucking calling the game.
Yeah, they fucking bring in the meat wagon, bring them off on the fucking stretcher.
And I just don't know how, what, there's three guys out there. Someone had to have been like, okay. And Pedersen's like got his hands up like, you know, fuck, please stop the game. This guy's...
He was like, what the fuck? What are these guys doing?
Yeah. Because he's the guy who took the shot, right?
Pedersen, Pedersen took the shot, I believe. It was someone on that point.
And
because it was on the power play, and I think Pedersen was up on the point.
Yeah.
The power play, moving around.
Yeah. And it harkens back to Werenski took a real bad one in the playoffs against Pittsburgh like 2 or 3 years ago at this time. And he's just pouring blood out of his face, and he's trying to get off the ice. And I always thought, you know, the rule there was if the player's bleeding, they stopped it. But that one went on, and Pittsburgh, I think, tied it on that goal power play and then won the game and then ultimately won the series against Columbus. But that was... It was brutal. I mean, they made T-shirts out of his face because the whole side of his face is fucking welled up. But he ended up sending a tweet out that was like, you know, this cannot continue to happen. Like, you guys want to fucking protect us? Stop the play.
We can't have this.
No. No. Not at the best league in the world.
No, you know, it's just, it's wild. That, you know, you usually you'd sit there and say, all right, whistle blown. The guy's sitting, laying there.
Well, wouldn't you just err on the side of caution anyhow?
That's what I mean. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's kind of just, like, weird that they didn't blow the whistle. But I know, like, the other team was on a power play and it has to be a change of possession, but they also have the right to blow it down.
Yeah, I just blow it down, and then if I get over there and he's playing fuck around, I'm like, okay, I'm going to remember you, and you're going to get some fucked up penalties coming up.
Yeah, here. Remember it.
Chalk, chalk.
Delay a game or whatever.
Yeah, exactly. There's shit you could do to, but I think you're right. I think you're dead on there where you just see him down and he's not even, he's trying to get up and can't. So it's time to blow the whistle.
I mean, most guys aren't like that in hockey. You wouldn't see it. Especially no one's going to lay on the ground like for 5 seconds and then realize, oh, they're not blowing this fucking down. I better get up. He was clearly hurt, you know?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And then I think what, two nights ago, a ref got hit, and he is down, and they stopped that motherfucker quick.
Oh, yeah. I think in that same game.
Was it really?
I think it was in the same game.
Good Lord. Yeah, it's not a good look, and they said the managers or the owners met about it, and they didn't really change anything, but I think that's something you'll see at the end of the year when they do their meetings, that I think that rule will change indefinitely.
Oh, yeah, that one was on Batman's desk in the morning.
Yeah, for sure. Well, dude, we got Thanksgiving rolling in next week. What do you got any traditions or anything that you do for Thanksgiving?
I think I'm going to my parents this year. What did I do last year? I think I did go to my parents. But yeah, this year I'm going to go to my parents. This back in Westfield, Mass. Good old Westfield.
Now, do you guys do anything like play cornhole or any kind of get the Monopoly board out or anything like that?
Ah, we'll watch football. We'll have a fire going. It's always like, you know,
nice.
Pretty calm. Some good ass fucking food. Some family.
Nice. Yeah, we're having it here at my house this year for the first time. So I'm pretty stoked. We'll have all the kids down in the basement partying, and I won't have to go anywhere.
You guys have relatives come up?
Yeah, I know my younger brother is coming in from Michigan. My mom and her boyfriend will be coming over, and then my brother. Recently just moved back from Kentucky, but he's back here in the hometown, so I think him and his family will be coming over as well. We switch every other year since my wife's from Michigan, so like Thanksgiving last year we were up in Flint, and then now we're...
How far is that from you?
3 hours to where we go in Michigan.
That's not too bad.
Nah, dude, Michigan is fucking gorgeous.
I've been a couple times.
It is.
But
if you can get there in the summer, dude, and go to like Escoda, go to like the coast on Lake Huron, it is fucking paradise, dude.
I would I'd love to go to one of the Great Lakes. I've heard it's fun up there in the summers.
Any one of them, man. Any one of them. Lake Erie's a little fucking grungy. It's like, you know, it's caught on fire a couple times. Like, it's
from what?
Oil spills, like chemicals in the fucking...
Jesus Christ. That's filthy.
Yeah, the Cuyahoga River has caught on fire, dude.
Jesus Christ. Fucking go swimming, come out with like a fucking...
Oh, yeah, you're getting...
Second nose on your forehead.
Yeah, dude, Cleveland, baby. Woo! Can't beat it. There's fucking psychos that surf up there in the wintertime, too, dude. They fucking stick their beer right in the snow, and, like, they're just crushing these fucking two-foot waves, man.
Yeah, that's a little fucking much. I mean, some guys are surf out here in the winter in Cape Cod, and I could never fucking do that. I don't know how guys do that, but the West dudes, obviously, that's now are pretty nice.
Nah, I'm not trying to do any of that. And I'm not trying to get in the fucking water. If I go take like a sauna, I'll jump in after that, like a fucking true Finn or some shit. But I'm not doing it just for I don't surf, so I'm not trying to do that.
Yeah, I've surfed a few times. It's fun. I went to San Diego last year. I'd rather go to San Diego and surf.
Did you go to the zoo?
I didn't go to the zoo, no. But that place is pretty fucking awesome, San Diego. If I had somewhere I'd want to go on the West Coast to live, that would probably be one of my choices.
Never been to San Diego. I don't even know where the fuck it's at. Is it down south California?
It's in Southern California. It's like it's pretty not far from Mexico.
Okay. I thought so. Yeah. I've been to San Francisco, and that's it in California. And I think that's up north more.
Yeah, I've only been to San Diego. That's the only thing I've been to. So, yeah, the only place I've gone to I'd want to live. But I've heard some fucking gnarly stories about, like, you know, Northern California is pretty awesome. Seattle, those places I'd like to visit for sure.
Yeah, until that bitch breaks off into the sea, man. L.A.'s fucking toast.
Yeah, Jesus, man.
All right, dude. Well, do you got any questions for me?
Oh, man. Fucking, I was going to ask you something. Oh, yeah. Your kids play hockey?
My 9-year-old does not. He's not too into it, but my 4-year-old daughter is in her Learn to Skate program right now. So she's getting started, man. It's pretty exciting.
Yeah, that's an exciting time for sure.
It is.
You're a hockey guy, so.
Oh, I love it, man. She gets out there and she's like, I'm like the TV. I'm like, oh yeah, dude.
I'm like the TV.
I'm like the TV. Well, I was telling your sister, Casey, last night. I was like, what's really cool is, like, you know, when she was younger, you know, Casey, she was watching the NHL. It's like, my daughter's watching you guys. I was like, so it's really cool that that she can visually see that there's a place to go. You know, like, if I work hard enough, I could potentially make the Olympic team or play in one of these leagues, you know, or hopefully play in a league that's, you know, with the NHL, with the women's league.
Yeah, and it's way more, you know, Casey, you'd see the Olympics on TV when she, you know, when we were younger. Now, all the exhibition games when they play Canada on TV, NHL Network, so.
Yeah, it's awesome.
A lot more of it being, you know, shown to America and other countries as well.
Yeah. My oldest son, he splits time with his mom in my house here. And then, so he, like, we'll go out in the garage and hit pucks and shit, and he likes it then. But there's not enough onus at his mom's house to, like, get off your ass and do something. I'm like, I told him, I was like, dude, I can't sign you up if I know that I can't guarantee that you're going to show up.
Right.
Like, you want to do anything, I'll pay for it, we'll get it going, but I don't have you through the week, so you can't just miss practice. That's not how shit works.
No. Yeah, you can't be just like, I want to go this day, but I want to go that day. It's got to be commitment.
Yeah, you got to go. You got to go. So, yeah, the kids are getting in it. My 2-year-old, she started skating last year, you know, just standing on the ice in her skates. It's pretty fucking...
Yeah, walking around.
Yeah, pretty adorable. So, but she's got that. She's got the fucking Corey Bellamy in her, dude. She's
spicy.
Dude, she's itching to get out there and fuck kids up, man. She's wild, dude.
She's gonna be high stepping, trying to bury someone in the corner.
Yeah. Oh yeah, for sure, man. She's nuts. She got out on the ice last practice. The door opened and she was out on her shoes. The lady coach had to go get her. I was like, oh my god, this fucking kid. She, like, waits, man, and she sees that door open. She's out. She's fucking gone. I'm like, where's Frankie at? And my wife's like, she's out on the fucking ice.
She's
like,
already out there.
So she's going to be interesting to see. And then if my youngest son doesn't play Boomer, he's only 9 months old, I'm going to kick him out of the house. So he's only got he's only got one option, man. That's cool, though. Yeah, you know, we'll be back next Saturday, man. Corey, tell them where to find you on the internet, man.
Yeah, just you find me on hockeyfights.com, obviously, Corey Bellamy.
Yeah, get on there. Get on there and vote on his fights. Get his fucking fights voted on.
See a bunch of my draws and my ass getting kicked. But, you know, it's all fun and fucking Instagram. Yeah, if you guys have any questions, anything you guys want to discuss, let us know.
Yeah, and you know, thanks to Doug for sending the question this week or the story and the few questions we had last week. Let's get a few more in this week, you fucks.
Yeah, thanks, Doug. Appreciate you, brother. Give me a call soon, and we'll get some food and some beers, brother.
There we go. For Corey Bellamy, I'm William Bartram. This is The Breakfast with the Biscuit, the song coming soon. We love you guys. Thanks, and we'll check you fucks next Saturday. We out.
Well, see ya.